Feeling a bit wheezy, short of breath, and have a tight chest? Well, those are all symptoms of asthma. But what is asthma? Well, firstly, asthma can be defined as a chronic inflammatory disorder of the airway that is associated with airway hyperresponsiveness, recurrent episodes of wheezing, breathlessness, chest tightness, and cough, which is known to be worse at night or in the early morning. The three classic characteristics are airway flow limitation, airway hyperresponsiveness, and bronchial inflammation. So what does this all mean? Well, normally in a healthy functioning lung, when we breathe in, we take in oxygen, and when we breathe out, we release carbon dioxide. The tubes are able to allow air to pass efficiently, but in asthma, things are not so simple. Now, these tubes are called the trachea, which splits into two primary bronchi. These then further branch into secondary bronchi, and eventually they branch into bronchioles. The importance of asthma occurs within these tubes. The walls of the tube contain connective tissue, smooth muscle, and glands. The opening of the tube is known as the lumen. This smooth muscle can change the shape of the tubes, and this is what is happening in asthma. When a person is having an attack, the smooth muscle contracts, making the lumen smaller, but the glands also secrete extra mucus. As you can see, the smooth muscle is contracted and the mucosal layer is now swollen. This means that the lumen is now a lot smaller than it should be, with the glands also secreting mucus. This is what gives the wheezing sound, as air bubbles pop in the mucus. This is the picture of asthma. But why would the body react like this? Well, first I must go over certain triggers for asthmatic attacks. These can be dust, animal fur, cigarette smoke, pollen, exercising especially when it's cold, some drugs such as aspirins, and emotional factors such as stress or laughing. There are some VIPs in the inflammatory response of asthma. Some of these are IgE antibodies. These are able to bind to allergens. Mast cells, these contain histamines. Dendritic cells, T helper cells, and eosinophils. Once an IgE antibody binds to an allergen, it can then go on to bind to mast cells, causing the release of histamines. This causes the smooth muscles to contract, causing the narrowing of the lumen. One of the dendritic cells' function is to uptake and present allergens to T helper cells. There are two types of T helper cells, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 normally promotes inflammation by the activation of phagocytes, lymphocytes, and the release of certain chemicals. This is known as cell-mediated immunity. Type 2 promotes inflammation through the production of antibodies. This is known as humoral immunity. Type 1 is often found in the lungs, however in asthma both can be found in the lungs as type 2 is upregulated. So what does this all look like when somebody's having an asthmatic attack? If an allergen is inhaled, this can cause dendritic cells to become activated and in turn attract T helper cells and allow them to differentiate into type 2 T helper cells. Type 2 T helper cells lead to the production of IgE antibodies. These can go on to bind to the allergens and interact with mast cells, leading to the release of histamines, which leads to the contraction of smooth muscles in the airway. Thank you for watching today's video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe to get more videos. I hope you have a great day.